many of you are already experiencing some form of greatness in your life? I am experiencing, I don't know about you, and it is not coming from outside, it is coming from that which is inside of me. And that is the pattern of God. You must let it manifest, you must make it be expressed. Praise the Lord. And so I began to say that Abraham is a symbol, you know, of blessing, is a symbol of greatness. And so we must take our clue from Abraham. The word of God says, you know that in Galatians 3, 13 and 14, that Christ has redeemed us from the curse of the law, having been made a curse for us, for cursed is he who hangs on the tree, that the blessings of Abraham might come upon the Gentiles through faith in Christ Jesus. And so Abraham is that symbol of blessing. And that is why we sing, Abraham's blessings are ours, you know. And one thing I want to tell you today is that Abraham operated under the frequency of obedience. And what does it mean to operate under the frequency of obedience? It means something kept occurring and occurring. And so at every point in time, Abraham was always being tested. Pastor has run through a lot of tests. There was the test of humility, there was the test of service, there was the test of hospitality, there was the test of prompt obedience. When God said to Abraham, stand up and circumcise yourself and members of your household, the next day he did it. When God said to Abraham, you know, cast out Haggai and Ishmael, he did not question God. When God said to Abraham, take your only son, the only son that you love, and go and sacrifice him as a burnt offering, the very next day, Abraham left and decided to go and obey God. So Abraham operated, and that was the secret of Abraham's blessings. Praise the Lord. And so if you want to operate in supernatural greatness in this season, you must be prompt to obey God at every point in time. Praise the Lord. Let's open our Bibles this morning to Isaiah chapter 1. Isaiah chapter 1, verse 19. Before I say that, I want to say something. There is no substitute to obedience. No substitute at all. You can't replace obedience with anything. Unlike prayer, that sometimes you may not want to pray, that you can praise. There is no substitute, no replacement to obedience. It is either complete or it is not complete. You know, prayer is not a substitute to obedience. Praise is not a substitute to obedience. Sacrifice is not a substitute to obedience. God, through the prophet Samuel, said to Saul in 1 Samuel 15, he says, it is better to obey than to sacrifice. You know, obedience is better than sacrifice. So sacrifice is not, you know, a substitute to obedience. Having a title in church is not a substitute to obedience. Being the longest member of Temple of Glory, we are here before Temple of Glory started, is not a substitute to obedience. Coming to church every day when the doors of this church open, it is not a substitute to obedience. Obedience is obedience. Obedience is obedience, and God demands obedience. Praise the Lord. So let's look at Isaiah chapter 1, verse 19. If you are willing and obedient, you shall eat the good of the land. If you are willing and you are obedient, you shall eat the good of the land. If you are willing and obedient, let's open our Bibles to Deuteronomy chapter 28. Verse 1. Now it shall come to pass, if you diligently obey the voice of the Lord your God, to observe carefully all the commands which I command you today, that the Lord your God will set you high above all the nations of the earth. That is greatness. Now it shall come to pass, if you diligently obey the voice of the Lord your God, to observe carefully all the commandments which I command you today, that the Lord your God will set you high above all the nations of the earth. Let's open to 1 Samuel chapter 15. Verse 22. So Samuel said, "As the Lord has great delight in burnt offerings and sacrifices, as in obeying the voice of the Lord, behold, to obey is better than sacrifice, and to heed than the fat of rams." So Samuel said, "As the Lord has great delight in burnt offerings and sacrifices, as in obeying the voice of the Lord. Behold, to obey is better than sacrifice, and to heed than the fat of rams." Praise the Lord. I want you to forget, one thing you should never forget is that there is power in obedience. Obedience commits the integrity of God to perform. Obedience, Pastor has shared here before, I think when he was teaching one of the tests of obedience, he talked about Bishop Oyedepo at a point that his daughter died. And the only prayer he prayed to God, he said, "Lord, if you've ever said anything to me to do and I did not do it, then let my daughter remain dead. And if you've ever, I've ever done anything that you did not tell me to do, then, you know," and God's integrity is committed when you can challenge God, you know, and say, "Lord, if I have not, then you need to act." Praise the Lord. And I know it works. You know, when I was believing God for children, it got to a point where, you know, because the word of God says faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence. When you have faith, you receive. It got to a point where I knew, and then my motto, my mantra then was, I do not believe in self-deception. I was not lying to myself. I knew with my whole heart I'd come to the place of absolute faith. I'd worked on my faith, trained myself so much that I knew. And I said to God, a day a friend came to visit me, and I was talking to her, and I said, "You see this thing, in the issue of faith, I know I have faith. So if God decides not to give me children, it's just because he says, 'Onyema, I want to use your life as a case study where you walked in faith but did not receive.'" I said, "Because if it is faith, I'm walking in faith." And that night, God answered me. Praise the Lord. He answered me immediately because I challenged his integrity. God answered me immediately. I had a dream that night, and I saw a pastor. You know, then I was attending Bible school in Living Faith. I didn't even know his name then. But he appeared to me in the dream. And you know, normally when a man of God appears to you in the dream, simply is a symbol of the messenger of God. You know, and he walked up to me in my dream. And the only thing he said to me in my dream, he said, "God's word shall not fail in your life." 6 weeks later, I was pregnant. Praise the Lord. So when you commit, there are certain things. Faith commits the integrity of God. Obedience is another thing that commits the integrity of God. If you walk in obedience, if you live a life of obedience daily, heeding the voice of God, obeying his word, his instructions, you know, the promptings of God in your spirit, being led by the Spirit of God, making sure you are in alignment with the will of God, you commit the integrity of God on your behalf. And so if you want, there are a lot of us that are going through a lot of things. If you've been going through so many things in your life and you've been working at it and you're not seeing results, perhaps you need to check your obedience level. Are you obeying God in everything? I know women who are trusting God for children, but they talk anyhow. They insult people. They say things to people. And then you expect you can commit the integrity of God. Faith is not a substitute to obedience. So you must be very careful in this time. So if you are going through anything in your life, you gossip, you lie, you do all sorts of things, and then you think, you know, that kind of thing, you want God to act on your behalf. God is not like that. Partial obedience is not obedience at all. It's either obedience, total obedience, or no obedience. And God is calling us. And all of us are guilty, you know, of disobedience in one form or the other. I won't say I'm a perfect person. And I believe that God is making a call to us this morning. You know that obedience, okay, I'll talk about it later. It was disobedience. I was going to talk about it under alignment, but let me talk, okay, I'll talk about it later. I believe God is giving us an opportunity this morning to start afresh with him. To make a commitment to God this morning, I promise you, I'll live a life of obedience day by day, moment by moment, minute by minute. Lord, I'll listen to your voice. I'll heed your voice. Your word says this, and I will do it. Some people are here, and I'm telling you, they are members of this church. They don't greet me. How can you expect God to work on? No, it's true. No, it's true. They're sitting and staring at me, and they think they are posing for me. Praise the Lord. I'll go and praise the Lord. So there is power in obedience. There is power in obedience. If you repent, the word of God says, if you hear the voice of God, do not harden your heart as in the days of rebellion. Do not harden your heart. And so you can go into obedience and go under a curse. And then you because disobedience brings a curse, obedience brings blessing. You know, sometimes you go to trials. There are two different kinds of trials and adversities in life. One is under a curse. Another is under a blessing. And so you must be able to discern what you are going through at every point in time. Whether what you are going through is under the curse because you've missed it in a way, or that God is taking you through a process and the end result is a blessing. And so when you discover that you are going through certain things in your life and you are able to discern, it's because you have missed it and you are out of alignment and you've missed the mark, you quickly go and repent. And God says He is faithful and He is just, you know, to forgive us our sins when we confess them. And to cleanse us of every unrighteousness. Praise the Lord. And so there's power in obedience. What does it mean when you say power? Power is the ability, you know, to accomplish things, to do things. And obedience is a force. Obedience is a force. You know, we have these three laws of Newton. The first one says an object remains in a position of rest until a higher and external force is applied to it. Obedience is a force. Check your life. If there's anything that is not adding up, the word of God says until you're obedient.